Hello everybody, welcome to another edition of Business Communication. Today we are going to talk about non-verbal communication. Now, non-verbal communication is pretty interesting because this is really not a word-based communication, and it really does not take place separately and independently from verbal communication. It can be used alone, or it is also a supplement to verbal communication. Now, let's see how we can have different aspects of non-verbal communication. The first, of course, is visual communication. And in visual communication, the methods used are to make it more effective. For example, you can see a histogram here, a bar chart, and it has been colored to denote the different the seeds of the various oils that are used as what we call energy recycling. So this is one form of visual communication, and visual communication takes place as a complement, which is most effective and most fruitful. Of course, along with visual communication, we also have gestures and postures and facial expressions, graphs and charts, color, etc. And all these together in a combination are termed as visual communication. Another form of visual communication is kinesics, or the body language. Here, it refers to the movements of different parts of the body that indicate some specific message. The physical movements of the body are unique non-verbal communication, and they can be conscious or unconscious. So you can see these graphics and denoting different things like I'm tired, or I'm sorry, I'm extremely sorry, or yes, we are guilty, or yeah, and all those things. So this is what we call kinesics, or body language. Then we go into gestures. Gestures also, you've got a number of gestures, which is basically a deliberate body movement intended to convey a specific message. And in gestures, there are different types of gestures which are specific to countries, specific to continents, and they can also mean offensive. They can also be denoted in different cultures. They can mean different things in different cultures and things like that. For example, this would be a sign of peace in very many ways. This would be a sign of good, or like, and this would be unlike or not good, and various things like that. Different cultures have different gestures, and it's nice for you, for business communications students, to learn various gestures, especially when you are planning to go abroad, or when you are planning to do a business in your hometown. Gestures will form an important part of visual communication. Posture is also another very important part of business communication, wherein the way you hold your body when you stand or sit. This is also a very important body language, and the manner in which you communicate your posture, or the way you carry yourself, is very important, and it can also convey specific meanings. Like, for example, you are standing like this. It would definitely mean something, as to when you put both hands, sometimes one inside your coat pocket, and things like that. So each posture could mean differently, and it is always important to understand what the meaning entails in your particular culture, and that is very important. The same way, the physical appearance is also another important thing. Physical appearance includes your clothing, the ornaments that you wear, especially for ladies, cosmetics, hair styling, that together you build up an image or a brand image or an image of you. So the totality of a physical appearance provides visual signals to the other person, or in terms of the person's interest or the age or the personality or the style or the attitude or the social standing or the religious affiliation and so on and so forth. So many things can be denoted just by your physical appearance, and the graphical icons show a person who's fat and thin and tall and short, young and old, whether it's a boy or a girl and things like that. So physical appearance also counts a lot. And as business students, business communication students or MBA students or BBA students, you all should see to it that your physical appearance is also you carry forward in a very good and nice manner. Then your facial expressions also count a lot, because a face is an important type of non-verbal communication, and it is also the index of your mind. Especially very smart managers can read a face as soon as you come in. If your face is looking glum or it's looking gloomy, immediately your manager can read and tell you what happened to you and things like that. So from joy to sorrow, from frustration to pleasure, all these things can be read through your face. So the entire face of a person is expressive, especially the eyes. So situations like happiness or surprise or fear or anger or sadness are identifiable forms in a person's facial expression. So see to it that you maintain a good facial expression, especially for interviews, and also whenever you see your boss and whenever you come into contact with a customer. Touch is also another form of non-verbal communication, which sometimes comes in first, because it might be a hug that you give to a business counterpart or to a colleague of yours. Communication by touch should consider also cultural patterns and individual preferences, because not very many people in different cultures accept a hug. It can be a namaste. Our Indian way of folded hands is also a very good expression of non-verbal communication. At the same time, there are other cultures like the Japanese culture where they bow down. So you should always know the type of culture that that you are going to visit, or the person whom you are going to interact with, and based on that, you will need to check upon the non-verbal communication of touch. And there is also proteomics, or the distance factor. Proteomics, or the distance factor, is the study of how we communicate with the space around us. And the space and distance can be a very powerful media conveying message. In many organizations, space has become an indicator of the relative importance of persons. So if you go to a manager's office, you know, the space is allocated for him. Or if you go to a workspace and you find it one particular table kept separately, so that importance of that space can immediately be understood by us. And nowadays, or with this event of COVID-19, distances have also become a common factor. And so you need to know the proteomics, or the distance of how you communicate. As the cartoon shows, the one person is clearly not very happy with the other person coming so close, with the chubby fat person coming very close to him. So these things are also very important in non-verbal communications, called the proteomics, or the distance. Then communication through action can also be another form of non-verbal communication, and action is one of the best ways to communicate a specific message. The liking and disliking, or the desire or nature or habits of a person, can be revealed by his action. And these are certain actions that I have taken from the internet. And you know, different actions that you show can have different meanings, and they are all another form of non-verbal communication. So suppose, for example, a manager comes to the office on time regularly. It means that he is very punctual and other employees should follow him. So this is also a particular way of communicating through action. The manager is showing you that he is on time, and because of that, the others need to follow his punctuality. So this is also communication through action. It can also be through symbols. Nowadays, symbols are very much in demand, and emojis or emoticons, as you used to call them before, they are now in vogue. So different signs or symbols to communicate a specific message to the viewers are also used. Especially the face is now shown as an emoji to express prohibition or to show loneliness or calmness or frustration or confusion or sad, and all these things. So emojis will be forming a very important part of nonverbal communications. It is now already in vogue, and it is only going to be more. So you need to even learn the different symbols and how you use them in nonverbal communication. And the last one is silent communication. Now, in silent communication, when the message is conveyed through silence, it is called silent communication. This can also be a very powerful tool for communication. Suppose I just keep silent for just 5 seconds. Now, this silence has conveyed either a positive message or a negative message. Now, it can be in a classroom. If the teacher keeps silent, that means the students have to, because of the change in the tonality or the change in the way the teachers talk, the teacher suddenly maintained a silence, then all the students will suddenly think, what has happened to the teacher? And, you know, everyone will keep silent. So, silent communication can denote attention. It can show carefulness, can even show carelessness, displeasure, lack of interest, approval or disapproval or refusal. All these things can be communicated very effectively through silence. So these are the different aspects of nonverbal communication. Please do have a look at it once more. Subscribe to the channel, because more are coming in the near future. Thank you. Bye.